Nada. I guess it's just us two tonight.
I remember Anthony said he was going to be at the race.
Yeah. Plus, he's on vacation too, so.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with the Conti because I'm fucking struggling with the like. What's it? I can only imagine with the Raycon. Damn. I guess I'm gonna wait and see too. Looks like temperature's dropping a little bit already.
Yeah. So you going with the looser one or a tighter one?
I'm probably gonna go with the benchmark one.
Okay. This looser one seems to be pretty good.
See, I'd heard that. That's what made me run it today was because I was in a race and P1 through 4 finished was Conti. One of them was running looser, or two of them was running looser, and Roach was running benchmark and tighter.
Yeah.
And then it was me in fifth with the Ryko, and then there was like two other guys behind me with the Ryko. I was like, fuck, maybe I should try that. There's Alex.
There he is.
Well, I'm going to start and park. I'm just going to literally run two laps. I'm going to park it.
That's right.
On my laptop. So.
What are you doing?
I'm going to run two laps just so I can get a few points. I'm on my laptop, so.
Oh.
I'm just using my mouse and keyboard.
Yeah. I did that a couple weeks ago, just started in part just to get the points. It worked. It saved me. Okay, I'm going to try this qualifying setup and see if it does as good as it did the last time.
The only thing I have to say is don't tell Chris, though.
Right.
I'm using my automatic bid for all the spots.
Yeah. Well, now I told Chris I was going to start in print, but I didn't tell him anything else. Uh-oh. I got two of them. Crap.
Which one are you looking at? The Ryko? Or?
Yeah.
I've been using the Q3.
Q3?
Okay, yeah.
I think
that's
the one I used.
It's been pretty good, but... I haven't run it on these track temperatures either, though, so.
Yeah, it's been rather warm. Warm is not a word for it. It's hot. Oh, it's back out to 128.
Fuck! God damn it, starting in the back.
Completely blew in turn one. Just, missed my breaking point. Oh, well.
Yeah, I lost it in turn one. I missed it. It slid way up the track anyway. And then
it did the same thing with me. Oh, no, though. It was good. From it. Yeah. I just tried to ride it on out and keep my momentum of it. Although it was handling pretty good up to that point. I just remember the note said to make sure you're pointed towards the inside when you hit the brakes.
Yeah.
And I wasn't. So it just kept going straight. Sure, change back to my race setup. That'd be bad.
Still kind of stuck though. 101 on the right side. Goddamn. I don't see it getting much below what the normal races start off. Like the high temperature races have been this week.
I know.
I'm going with the Connie. Fuck it. I might regret it, but.
Well, we'll both regret it. So.
I mean, it's competitive either way. I just feel like it's more stable.
Yeah.
I feel like I can get a little bit more speed out of the Ryko, but.
Yeah, that's the way it feels to me, so. And as I like something that's predictable. I know how it's going to do.
Right.
All right. I just say last week I had a great setup last week and then got demolished on lap 15, and of course Claude calls it a racing deal, so nobody got a fault for it.
All right, I'm gonna use the bathroom and stuff real quick. Well, I got 5 minutes or four, 5 minutes left.
Yep, I'm gonna grab me a drink right quick too. Oop, wrong one. Thank you. One way to pit in. 23rd fastest. I just finished one of these races. Time to go. Same. Good luck. Yes, good luck. Telemetry's on. What is taking telemetry?
Alright, I'm back.
Hurry in.
Alright, here we go.
Yeehaw. Good luck, man.
I guess we'll find out in a few laps whether I'm going to regret this or not.
Yeah, I'll be right behind you, hopefully.
My wife just told me if I lose, I'm sleeping on the couch. I told her she better go and get it ready for me.
Thought it hurt her. Kavaja's voice kind of changed. I have finally gotten buttons programmed for my pit stop now.
Good luck, bud.
Good luck.
There we go. You can take off in first, but back here, I'd suggest not. That's got doored.
Oh, one's loose.
Yeah, that's the one that doored me. Where's Record? He get banned?
I don't think so, but I haven't seen him in a while.
Yeah, he hadn't been here the last few weeks. Over.
Yeah, I
Last time I seen him, he got into me, and then he wrecked somebody else, and,
yeah, that was the last I heard of, too.
And I told him I was going to report him or whatever, and then I messaged him. I was like, you know, I'm going to be the better person. I was like, you know what, dude? I'm not gonna turn it in because I don't want to be the guy that gets you banned. I was like, you got to realize nobody wants you here, bro. And like, you're not slow, you're fast. You're just way too fucking aggressive. Just chill out. And he's like, well, thank you for not getting me banned or whatever. And I was like, yeah, it ain't no problem. Just watch what the fuck you're doing.
Yeah. I mean, it's one thing to have talent, but man, you got to know how to use it.
Yeah.
He just too impatient. But I haven't seen him, man. I didn't see him on the suspension list.
Temperature went down a little bit. It's still hot as fuck, man.
Oh, I ain't getting in the middle of this. Oh, that was fun.
You good?
Yeah, that was good. Had me in a 3-1, I was like, oh, no. Got my butt out of that. I say, it's too early to be doing that. I'll let them get up here and wreck themselves, and I don't have to worry about it.
Fucking hornet's nest right where I'm at for the next like 10 cars is all bunch.
Yeah, I can see you. You can almost make a pass on the outside. And just, I don't think there's a groove there yet.
You can probably do it. You're probably going to burn your shit up in the process.
Yeah.
I'll just wait for them. They're going to overshoot the turn and you can get underneath them at some point.
Yeah.
As I say that, I get stuck on the outside. Oh, got drove up the door again.
Yeah, they're sliding up pretty bad in the turns.
You know what I always wondered when NASCAR is racing? How do they get the track temperature?
That's a good question.
Are they basing it off pit road temperature? But no, the groove would be
I know that
hotter.
There's sensors in the track, and they get readings from that. Now, I don't know. Really? I guess they relay it to the, pit crews. I'm sure they have it. Open their little computers. It tells them all the track temp and wind and everything is.
I just almost fucked up big time.
What'd you do? What happened?
Not where I was at, down something to third going into fourth.
Oh.
That motherfucker wound out and I hurried up and shifted it back and got lucky.
I keep forgetting to shift up.
Yeah, I don't shift up on the back. I just do it on the front.
Yeah. And every time I get in turn one, I keep getting the downshift. Of course, there's times where you won't have to.
You know, I didn't have that problem all week, but I was in the last race I was in today, I kept forgetting the downshift on the one.
Yeah.
God damn it, here goes Ron Fitton when he missed it.
Oh no.
He said the first stage is 90?
Yeah.
Wow.
I was kind of warning her about that. I was just, he sure has got that right. Then I looked at the NASCAR's website and that's what theirs are. I'm like, oh, well. Guess so.
Come on, Ron, get the fuck out of the way. Okay, he's slowly burning his shit up because he's sliding way up the track, so I've just got to be patient, I guess. Finally, Andre, now watch him run this turn harder shit so I can't pass him. And he does. Oh, went down to the grass, down to the grass, down to the grass.
Oh, hang on to it.
Well, I had him.
Oop, I see a lot of smoke.
Yeah, he all that forward.
Thanks again. Oh no. He always gives trouble.
I mean, I got underneath him. I passed him. He dove in the next corner and slingshot me. And, so I got back underneath him off the corner because he had overshot the turn trying to dive by me.
Yeah.
And then I overshot the turn and just gave him like a little zero X in the door and kind of shoved us both up the track. Yeah. Well, now he's trying to send me out because I guess I did that.
Oh, man. He's a little petty. He don't like being touched.
I even told him my bad when I did it, but I don't know.
Yeah. You got people that's like that. They think you're not supposed to touch them. They don't realize it's a race car. That's part of racing.
Right. You know what the problem is our racing used to be all about it's a racing move. Now they're changing. You know what I mean? People report you. There is no such thing as a racing move anymore.
I know.
Now I understand sometimes there needs to be a finer line between a racing move and this dumb shit, but you can't just say that, oh, you should have stayed in line and not went for it. That's bullshit.
No, that's not racing.
And it don't make a fuck whether it's for P1 or P31. You know what I mean? Every position counts.
If you don't try for a position, there's no point in racing at all.
Exactly.
I know. Some people just don't get that. They think, well, if you're not winning, what's the point of it? You're like, oh, okay. You really don't get racing at all, do you?
I can hear people on here complaining all the time about lap cars, which I'm famous for it too, and I get it.
Yeah.
It's very fucking frustrating, but we forget they got every right to race just like we do. Try to tell Ryan Newman he can't race him if he's getting lap.
Oh, yeah. My daughter's over here laughing at me. She said, you lean any forward there over in that chair, you're going to fall out. I'm like, I know. I'm trying to get the car to turn. Oh, man, we're only halfway to the... No, we're not even halfway. Definitely not going to make it on fuel.
Oh, Tim Cook coming on strong and then he was strong.
Things definitely handling better with a lot of fuel load.
Temperature ain't dropped at all since the start. What a sin sim time.
oh, that's what the race would normally be in.
No, like what time is it?
Oh, in the sim, I think it's been like 3:52,
almost 3 o'clock. Yeah. And which is weird because the race started at 3:30. Why would it start at 1 o'clock in here or 2:30?
Yeah, something like that. But yeah, the actual race started at 3:30.
Oh, I know why. I bet you. Because Chris is Central Time.
Yeah, that's right, he is.
He's an hour behind. So it would be 2:30 for him, but it's 3:30 for us. So it's making the track temperatures hotter overall.
I was starting to wonder about that.
Maybe we should let him know that.
Yeah.
I think our racing bases it off of Eastern time, right?
But yeah, because that's where they are. They're in Maine.
Which is, I guess, though, really, there, 2:30 in the evening, though, is still, it's still going to, yeah. So he would be right, because he's in Nashville. It's going to be the same temperature regardless.
Oh, yeah. I mean, now, it don't be a few degrees difference.
The only thing about it, it would start dropping sooner.
Yeah. We should start dropping now. Uh-oh, Pruitt's in a pit. What happened?
Who did?
Richard Pruitt. He's in the pits. Unless that's his pit stop. I mean, because we're all going to have to pit before the break.
Let me tell you what I did the other day. I was running P5 in a race.
Yeah.
And we had a caution lap 22, bro. And I started saving fuel under a caution. And we had another caution, too, I want to say. Nobody pitted. And I saved. And I made it all the way to end from lap 22. Ran out, like, soon as I crossed the line.
Oh, wow.
And I did it, and in the NIS the other night, I saved fuel, was leading, and saved just enough, and getting, literally got past as soon as we got to the line, and I've ended up finishing second. But I had dominated that race, and if I would have just pitted, I'd been fine, but I was like, I want to see if I can make it.
Yeah. Well, that was pretty good then. That's why I like these longer races. You can use strategy like that. Those leads that I used to race in, they were, you know, all fit set up, and, you know, they're shorter distances, usually less than half. And you just didn't have time to do anything, which you couldn't really change anything anyway.
It is so hard to pass on the bottom right now.
Yeah, it is.
You can catch the person in front of you, but getting around them is a whole nother subject.
Yeah.
You can't get on that throttle like you... Got loose again. God damn.
I think a lot of people are. I know I am.
I'll end up a lap down before the end of the stage.
Catching four cars in front of me. I had no idea how I'm going to get around them. Logan's going to be the first one.
I've got to tighten this thing up on exit a little bit.
Yeah, I think I need just a little bit.
I'm fine as long as I can let the car just float out to the wall where it wants to go.
Yeah.
But if I'm under somebody, I'm fine.
Yeah, if you have to cut down just a little too much coming off, yeah, it gets loose. Which reminds me, I need to go ahead and put that in my pits. Set up. Oh! What was that?
That would be nice for the caution right now, and I'm fucked up.
I'm not sure how that was on the caution. I had a car decide to go in the pits, just came to a stop. Didn't say nothing. So I'm screwed again.
I wonder if I should put in now. Drop 2 degrees.
Oh, I didn't get a chance to set it.
I think I'm gonna fit in this time. I went up a half a pound on left rear tire pressure.
Yep, that's what I did.
Bennett should be wrecking soon, as loose as his truck is.
I know.
Damn, I went down 2 laps, dude. Well,
I don't know, so I can't figure out how you go down. I mean, there are 30-second laps, I guess. That's why.
How'd I end up a lap ahead of you?
I got a penalty coming in. I didn't think I sped, but it must have been just enough that it got me. And held me for 40 seconds on top of that. That change helped it.
Not one lap, but.
29 hitting. Be nice if more people did that.
God damn it!
Uh-oh, what happened?
Fucking smacked the wall.
Ah.
We probably should have went the tighter setup, man.
I'm beginning to wish that myself. But on that change I made has helped it, though. A lot.
What'd you do? Go a half pound up here?
Yep.
I mean, that's helped it a lot, that's for sure.
There's nothing else I'd do a half pound in the right front. Right now, it seems to be doing pretty good. Didn't have to come up the track and hit me.
Oh.
I don't know if you saw that or not, but for some reason just came up and smacked me. I don't know if he got loose or what.
Prenson.
Yep.
He must be playing the fuel game.
He's slow as hell. Has he got a flat?
Just got to remember, if the temperature does end up dropping back down to normal, we need to take that half pound back out.
Oh, yeah.
Brenton's putting. We're going to be on the same team next year or what?
Oh, yeah, I hope so.
Me too. Okay. I mean, do you usually race in the off season or not?
Yeah, I do. Just to, you know, keep familiar with it, keep up with the changes.
Off season, we need to get together and do a bunch of practice.
Oh, we can definitely do that. I mean, I love racing. I'll do it any time of the year.
be nice to come in next year and to surprise everybody. So, like, where'd these guys come
from? Yeah, really. Yeah, we still got some time this year. I'm thinking that spinning in the trucks, we're starting to show them, but you know, what we can do. That's the one thing I hit about last week, was that setup I had was so good, but got ruined by a wreck.
I'm just missing something in these cars, and I can't quite figure out what the fuck it is.
I'm the same way. There's some tracks that I can do well at, like Kansas. I was really good at Kansas, and then once again got caught up in a wreck. Super speedways, Atlanta, but now there are other tracks like Darlington and stuff, and this track that I just can't get the, I don't know, this car just confounds me. That independent rear suspension is just messing me up.
I did it again, down shift to the third.
That's one reason why I hate shifting. I'll occasionally do the same exact thing, thinking I'm in the wrong gear and downshift one too many. Yeah. Low power applied.
Eric Heitman's just growing, dude.
Yeah. Something's not right with the car. It suddenly started getting a little loose, and I can feel something in the steering banging around. Like I got a tie rod loose or something.
You don't have a meatball, do you?
Yeah, I mean, it said I had wheel damage from where that car caught me going in a pit road. But I, apparently it's getting worse.
Down sitting in the third again. I just keep getting lucky as shit, I ain't reckoning.
Well, that's a good thing. Go ahead, team. You're clear.
I'm lagging. Done.
Uh-oh.
I got wheel damage. My car is fucking froze.
That's what mine's doing right now. I'm just barely hanging on to it. I'm waiting for it to break completely.
Well, there goes my race.
Oh, man. Man, we always having bad luck.
That's weird. Like, before it would just, like, temporarily lag out for, like, a split second. That time, it just, like, went out, come back in, went out. I was like, what the fuck is it coming back? And then when I come back, I was in the wall.
Oh, Lord. Well, one of these days, that black cloud's going to get off of us. All good, man. Hey, thanks for trying to do that, Derek. It was nice. Yeah, I've got a little bit of wheel damage anyway, so I'm going to spend a little time in the pits. Definitely is not feeling right.
Page. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm still in here?
Yeah, still going.
I'm watching the end of this race. We're in the second overtime and the whole field's about to run out of gas.
Oh goodness. Who's running? Who's winning?
Denny, and then it's Larson. Chastain was just up there, but Larson just wrecked him.
Oh, man.
And Kyle Busch is up there, but everybody's about to be out. The only person that people that's good is Corey LaJoy and a couple, like, bunch of no-name. Josevar. And most of these are saying they're probably not going to make it, but there's no point in putting. So, Josevar, LaJoy could get their swing.
Yeah. Be nice if some no-name did win.
They reckon. Another college, another green light checker. They can't make it now.
Oh no.
There ain't no way they can make it. Justin Haley's crew chief just came on. He's like, we're about to win this race.
Hey, anything's possible. Especially if they're really low on fuel. You're good, Steve. I'm just riding back here.
Fucking Bubba Wallace sending it four wide, dude.
Of course.
He sends it four wide, and the 77 had to check up because it stacked the whole field up. Might not have to fill that.
I'll do it.
Yeah. Another wreck.
Oh my gosh.
Oh no.
They're all gonna run out of fuel.
Thank you.
No way in hell Denny stays out this time. Fucking nursing with the crate off and...
Go ahead. That
ran out of fuel as soon as they went green and Bush ran him over and wrecked. This is like the fifth overtime.
You agree, but I think they did well. I forgot, it's unlimited in NASCAR.
Yeah, it is now.
I bet you after this they'll put a stop to that.
Remember they used to have it and something happened.
Yeah, I thought it was like three and that was it.
Yeah, it was, and then something happened that was controversial and then they were like, fuck it, but let's get rid of it.
Then they went to that, if, you know, the take the white flag, then doesn't matter. Anything happens after the white flag, it's the race is still on. It's over. I wish we had that.
But the people still stayed out, which is... Running the mixed race is probably a mistake.
Uh-oh.
Now Logano's leading. Logano, Briscoe, LaJoy, Smith, and that Chase Elliott. Man, I'd love to see a no name win it.
I know. It'd be nice.
I actually clicked the fucking power button on my keyboard, now the race is start.
Oh no.
I'm about to miss a start. Of course, and this son of a bitch will go fast as shit until I'm in a hurry to get in, and it takes fucking forever.
Yeah.
This guy's gonna win this bitch. Oh shit. Here comes Zane Smith. Oh shit. Hard fly. James missed that. Toss it again.
Oh no.
What the fuck?
Have they lost our minds? What is going on?
Josh Berry spun out this time.
Oh.
A Chase Elliott's out of fuel. Hey, I didn't miss the start, but I didn't miss the actual start.
Some bad thunderstorms rolling through.
My fucking computer just did something weird as shit. What the fuck? You know, like when you point out the pits and it has the speedometer?
Oh, yeah.
Nothing else lagged but the speedometer. It was weird as shit.
Yeah, that's unusual. What, would you believe we finally had our first caution? I thought this thing was going to go caution free.
Really?
Needs to pass me.
Thank you.
They finally took the white flag. Red X met the pass on guy. Bro, he literally come from last. And he's all over his on his back. Logano won.
Well, had to be somebody.
And of course, they're wrecking across the line. Zane Smith finished second.
Oh.
Ryan Priest fourth. You know what's bad? I can come in official races and not getting wrecked. But going to league race and I race with the same people every weekend and always end up bullshit.
Yeah, it's weird. I'm the same way. I can get in NIS races and shoot, usually have a good race. Getting here with a bunch of people I know, or not exactly know, but race with all the time and all hell breaks loose. Oh well, it'll get better. Hopefully.
I started from the pit, and in one green flag lap, I'm up to P14. position you in?
What's that?
What position are you running in?
May back up to 28th.
That's something I need to focus on next year. Staying in races, man. I'm so horrible about... Especially when I got a fast car and know I got a fast car and get damaged and know it just ruins my race.
Yep.
But I can stay in and still get a decent finish and just don't do it.
Yeah, that's what happened last week with the Xfinity race. Had a good car, fast setup, had a top 10 car, really. And I think, well, actually all of us got taken out except for me and Alex. But, you know, I finished same place I started since I stayed in it. So I didn't lose any points. I actually gained one position, so...
Hey, what was those setups you set today? Is that the D cars?
The Rocco and the ones that you posted. I unzipped them and posted them.
Was it the D car setup?
The Team Conti?
No, the Rocco ones you posted today.
Oh yeah, I posted those. They had some updated qualifying setups.
Gotcha, I haven't ran them at all this week. You just let me know which ones you're going to get.
Okay.
And that way we don't buy the same ones, you know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
I can get TWRS ones too, and I think the Premier ones.
Yeah, the Premier ones, I can get those too.
I'm in this chat that it's a bunch of us. Well, not a bunch of us. It's only like five or six of us.
Yeah.
And there's a bunch of people in there, but only like five or six of us has access to a certain channel in there. It's a setup folder.
Yeah.
And what it is we all buy, but each one of us buys a setup, and we all post them in there. That way we can all get it. We almost got caught because one guy invited another guy, which is, I don't think the guy meant to do it.
Yeah.
But he was running, he got the Rico set up and was running it and was like, and was in the race, and somebody asked him what setup he was running, and he said Rico. And just so happened, what's the dude's name that runs Rico? I can't remember his name, but anyway, he was in there.
Oh no.
Ken Byron or whatever. He was in there and was like, messaged him and was like, where did you get the Rico set up from? Because you haven't bought it this week. And he told him, like, I got it from this group, blah, blah, blah. This dude gave it to me. I'm like, what the fuck? So we ended up bullshitting our way out of it, like, but they don't know where the setup originated from. If they did, then they would probably, and of course it originated from me. But if he knew, he don't know, I'm in the group, so, but if he knew, he'd probably cut me off, you know what I mean?
That was me, Claude. Oh. It finally broke.
Yeah, Ryko, they're hard on track and shit, man.
Oh, yeah. Premier says they are, but I haven't seen anybody get in trouble yet. And like I've shared their setups too. That's where the ones that I've posted come from. Of course, I've worked on them.
So. Definitely Ryko, if you share, make sure you trust that person, dude.
Oh yeah. That's why I only put it in that our race chat. But the premieres hadn't been that great until last week. Now that Xfinity setup I ran, of course I had to use the Toyota. But it was perfect in that Toyota in New Hampshire. I loved it. It was great, but that's the first one I've gotten from Premier that was worth anything.
Yeah, they've been coming on pretty good in the Cup setups here lately.
Yeah.
Of course, this leaked Chicago street course. I won't. A lot of people don't buy the road course setup just because they don't run them or
they're
not good enough to really matter on the setup, you know, like most of us on road courses.
I don't know if they've changed any. Well, the car has changed. I'm going to try out the old setup I have from last year just to see if there's any difference. If there is, if anybody wants to run, then, you know, I'll get either Premier or something like that. I'll let you know which one I'm getting. I don't really know. When it comes to road courses, there's only so much you can do with them.
Right, because everything's got to be so equal.
Mm-hmm.
Do the same adjustments you do on an oval, you're going left, and that's it.
Yeah, really. You pretty well know what to do, but on a road course, it just depends on how many turns left you got and how many turns right, and you try to set up for either one or the other. Well, that's my race. It broke. It finally got loose coming out of four, and it would just went for no reason. I don't know what happened. I felt something jerk. I'm not sure it wasn't my wheel. I hope not. It better not be. But I'm got too many faults in this series to chance getting another one with the way it's running now. Not to mention we got some bad thunderstorms outside too.